Well, hello there, and welcome to yet another episode of One Credit Champ, where I put a credit into an old arcade machine, yada, yada, yada. You know the deal, you know the deal. And I've got two very important questions to ask. Firstly, does anybody want any Bourbon biscuit? Because I've recently acquired a whole lot of Bourbon biscuit. And secondly, what are we playing today? Because I guess that's important, right? And today's game is Chase HQ 2, so let's put the credit in, let's press start, and we get to choose a car here, either a cop car, some old American muscle car, or a sleek sports car. Well, it's more in tone with the original games that we pick the sports car, right? And hello, hello! It's Nancy, everybody! Nice to have Nance back on dispatch, and we're after a serial killer. Right you are, and there he is, avoiding the fuzz in his shiny red motor. Time for us to put on our woo-woos, and let's go, Mr. Driver, as this is Chase HQ 2, released by Taito in 2006, and the fifth arcade game in the Chase HQ series, following Chase HQ, Crime City, Special Criminal Investigation, and then Super Chase Criminal Termination. Oh, fuck, I forgot. If you count Quiz HQ, it's the sixth. That makes the name more than a bit silly, doesn't it? Anyway, as with previous titles in the Chase HQ series, our job is to catch up with the criminal's car and smash into it so much that it breaks down so you can arrest them for their evil ways. I mean, why mess with a perfectly good formula such as that, eh? To aid you in catching up, your car is equipped with a turbo, but unlike the previous games, you start the level with only one charge and have to pick up more en route, as it were, which is a blessing and a curse, as while you don't start out with free, you aren't limited to free. Well, we finished that one off rather sharpish. Your next Sonny Jim Milado Jim, bake him away, toys. Now he's captured and we get a number of points, 747 to be exact, and we're promoted to rookie. Okay then, which reminds me of something that I must speak of, but let's get Nancy to tell us who our next caller is first. And he's a bank robber, and he's in a monster truck. Okay, I mean, as getaway vehicles go, you'd expect somebody to go with something a bit faster and more compact. But then again, I guess it comes with certain advantages. Alright, back on topic, Uncle Mentus. As you saw in the results screen, as you play through the game, you increase in police rank from trainee to rookie to patrolman, all the way up to captain. Which begs the question, who's driving the car here? Now, we've played all the past games here on One Credit Champ long, long ago. Have a look for them on the channel if you want, but they're from years ago and the presentation looks a bit embarrassing for me now. So excuse me if I don't directly link you. But if there's one thing we can gather from the original Chase HQ games, is that they have very specific characters driving the car. Two veteran cops that went by the names Tony Gibson and Raymond Brody, who in the first game looked a bit like Crockett and Tubbs, but as time went on were clearly modelled on Riggs and Murtaugh from the Lethal Weapons. And the thing is, if we start out as a wet behind the ears trainee in this here game, what happened to Tony and Raymond? I mean, I guess it's been 20 years since the first game, so perhaps they've been promoted to cushy desk jobs, or maybe even retired. Which begs the question, why is Nancy still looking so young? Maybe it's Nancy's daughter and she's also called Nancy. As we all know, Nancy was replaced by Karen in SCI, and I always presumed that perhaps she was on maternity leave. It all adds up, which leaves another question. Who's the baby daddy? Who's Mr. Nancy? I get the feeling it might be Tony Gibson. He seems the type to knock her up. Don't know why. Well, there we go. That's Mr. Bank Rob Me Dude captured. And well, we didn't go up by many points that time, did we? And Nancy ain't impressed. That much is certain. Who's next on the list, Nance? Zoom it in a bit so I can see. Right, dangerous driving by stolen car. By the looks of it, he's stolen a stock car. And he's driving it on the racetrack. Oh, fuck me. That's the wrong way around the racetrack. Whilst the race is going on. Yeah, that's a bit dangerous. I mean, I'm no expert on NASCAR, but can't they red flag the cars down? Suspend the race? I mean, at least get a pace car back out so it isn't quite so deadly. Is that too much to ask? Never mind. Anyway, while I attempt to apprehend this perp, perhaps it's time to do the whole shtick I usually do about what consoles and computers this came out on for home consumption. And the answer is, it didn't. No home ports, none at all. The thing is that by the 2000s, you were getting to that point where straight up arcade ports just weren't enough for home release. And you were very lucky if arcade games made it to console at all. Just look at the amount of arcade games that Sega have made in the last 20 years post-Dreamcast that have been absent on consoles. And Taito's output has been a hell of a lot less. You see, in 2005, Taito were bought by this little-known company called Square Enix. Yeah, and after that little acquisition, the Taito logo became somewhat of a rarity to see on your Xboxes, PlayStations and Nintendos and that, outside of wacky remixes of Space Invaders. Maybe, just maybe, Squeenix and Taito will dig the franchise up from wherever they buried it one day to exploit it again, but I don't hold out much hope. And speaking of hope, got absolutely no hope of knocking this car out before the time is over. No, that's it. It's all over for us. I'm just going to stop here for 20 seconds and cause a massive pile-up on the racetrack. Is that cool with everybody? Is that cool? Yeah? All right then, I'll just sit here. Center of the racetrack. Yeah. Yeah. Right, it's time to put our name in, and we can have 5 whole letters to play with today, so we can extend our regular bum entry. Oh, yes, we can. So there's the B, there's the U, there's the M. Let's do another M, and let's put an O at the end for the Bummo. Oh, yes, and where has Bummo come? Bummo is in first place. Congratulations, Bummo. You success. Well, that's it for this one. Time for me to attack a giant biscuit. And this could take some serious effort. So if you don't hear from me within a week, just wait longer. Until next time, bye.